Authority is a word that gets misunderstood. I used to work as a librarian, a profession that's also misunderstood. Librarians just want people to read freely. Nudity, bomb making, it doesn't matter. And that's because librarians refuse to be the thought police. They know that when you give in to prissy fearmongers, you end up on a slippery slope that erodes our intellectual freedom. That's why we still have the USA Patriot Act and FISA. So librarians care more about substance than fashion. Is something worthwhile and relevant? And that's what I mean by authority. Who made it? What do they actually know? Who paid them for it? And does the person using it have a high or a low risk need? For example, Berkeley professor Paul Duguid spent 3 months trying to get 5 mistakes out of a Wikipedia entry on Daniel Defoe, and when it became 9 mistakes, he gave up. So it's more of a gistopedia, but it's fine for low risk needs or books by Chris Anderson at Wired. But if you're facing cancer, you want what's reliable. You want books, you want clinical trials, you want peer-reviewed research. But reliability is getting harder to determine. We have fewer gatekeepers against pure profit motive. For over 100 years, we trusted these companies to rate our investments, and they sold us out. But beyond that, we have more voices, we have more channels for expression, and less clarity about what it means as a whole. But I think we want that story. Culture is a conversation that happens across time, like a cloth made of the strongest threads. But whose voices matter most? Our cultural fabric is getting broader and looser. It's harder to see a pattern. Maybe we're in the age of fragmentation. And that's okay. I got an English degree once. At the time, the literary canon, like an actual canon, exploded. We didn't read Ethan Frome as a tragic love story. Through a feminist lens, it's a story about who gets to tell the story and why. Women don't say much in Ethan Frome. We also read Henry James, who created the modern novel, but we quickly left him behind to reclaim lesser-known voices from America's Gilded Age, and I didn't miss him a bit. Many books later, I work as a user experience designer. I pull fragments together and I let people play with them. I add social media, chatty ways to find, make, and point to other fragments, like an endless cocktail party. But when I get tired of all the self-puffery, I miss Kurt Vonnegut. In his last book, Man Without a Country, he rails against the guessers, people in charge who only sound authoritative. We all spread opinions now, but depending too much on the guessers is dangerous. Take Vonnegut's hero, the Hungarian Ignaz Semmelweis. Before germ theory, Semmelweis saw Viennese doctors cutting corpses, then delivering babies. A lot of women died from infection. He asked the doctors to wash first, and they only did so to mock him, but women stopped dying, so they fired him. He died in an asylum from an infected injury, a final critique of the guessers. Speaking of that, I miss critics, not thumbs up, 5 stars reviewers, critics who carefully discuss what a piece of art means, how it connects to influential works, why it's important or not, and they don't do it to be popular. When they explain the importance of Tom Stoppard's plays or why Zadie Smith's novels are merely clever, they are passionately teaching us how to look at work for a given medium, how to think about it, and how it fits into a larger story. They're glue in our fragmented state, and we're running low. Sometimes you need super glue, but we're losing long-form stories on the abuse of power. Last year, 8,000 journalists lost their jobs. Investigative work costs more, and they produce less, so they're fired first. But Bill Keller at the New York Times says, investigative work requires experienced reporters going places, bearing witness, digging into records, developing sources, all backed by editors who try to enforce high standards. It takes professionals time and money, and not just any money. Money without strings. The free agent reporters at True Slant market themselves, get ad revenue, and all without much editorial oversight. One of them admitted you could easily become cozy with your sources. The Wall Street Journal wants micropayments, but we're such brats when you force us to pay for something. Maybe the PBS way then, fewer ads and more appeals to our better nature, or more journalism through nonprofits like ProPublica, but we need investigative reporting that's free from influence. Theirs is the stuff of history and defense of the public good. I miss humility and shared experience. Now we have on-demand echo chambers that tell us only what we want to hear. Poor Emily Dinkinson, how dreary to be somebody, how public like a frog, to tell your name the livelong day on some amphibian blog. Studs Terkel used to talk about our common humanity on the radio. Ira Glass still does. Maybe story is the authority that we need now. A common ribbon to tie us together. Our story, and a respected place for those who tell it. Thank you.